Hey everyone, this is PBR 217 from Lighthouse Commander. So yeah, that's a bit of a different rotation, isn't it? Now this battle was actually pretty good. You know, the title may be a bit exaggerated, I admit, but it's still definitely very creative. So they lead off with a Vaporeon and Ambipom. At first glance, this looks pretty standard, but trust me, the things that this guy did was actually really good. I will admit, this guy impressed me quite a bit. Right, so he goes for a curse with Vaporeon, and I saw that move, I thought, what? Curse? I never see that. Hardly ever. I don't think I've ever seen a curse Vaporeon. Most of them are either special attackers or bulky water types. So I'm like, okay, this could be different. I better get rid of this thing. But even with Thunder Punch, I failed to one-hit KO it. I should have gone for that right from the beginning. Oh my god, I did try to go for that from the beginning. But Fake Out stopped me. And he goes for a fling with Ambipom. Yeah, obviously he was aiming to stop me, but unfortunately because I'm Choice Scarfed, I'm faster than Ambipom. Go for a Hydro Pump here, and it almost KOs, but doesn't quite knock it out. But I don't think it matters, because I believe I used Toxic on him in the first turn. And he of course goes for another curse here. You know, so yeah. Yeah, but that is actually pretty cool, but unfortunately, an Ambipom knocks out, but I think the Ambipom may have done its job, at least to a degree anyway. So in our knockout is Ambipom now, and I'm like thinking, what the heck is that Vaporeon gonna do? So he brings in this awesome thing that's Manectric, and I really did screw up here. Well, actually, no, I didn't screw up, I forgot. I didn't know that Manectric had Lightning Rod. I thought it was just static, and of course because of that I was unable to knock out the Vaporeon, you know. And of course, look, yeah, Thunder Punch isn't going to do that much to you know, Manectric, sorry, and he goes for a Baton Pass, and I thought, oh great, what have we got here, what's he going to Baton Pass to? Obviously a physical attacker. Oh great, it's Hitmonchan. You have got to be kidding me. That thing is going to pack a wallop from the Gaton Passes from Vaporeon. So I bring in 9 talents now, because I actually don't know why. No fairness. Yeah, I'll go for a Fake Out on Manectric, and I do actually knock it out. That's pretty cool. So yeah. So he goes for a Mach Punch on 4. Oh crap, that is not good. He's basically counteracted the speed problem with, you know, what's his face? Yeah, we've basically counteracted the downside to speed with Mach Punch's priority. That is actually a pretty creative strategy. I've hardly seen that these days, you know. And Vaporeon goes for a Waterfall. I suppose that does make sense, given the fact that it's a curse Vaporeon. And he knocks out both my guys. I thought, blubbing heck. I am actually being quite badly beaten here by creativity. Goes to show that creativity does sometimes come through for you. In fact, no, it doesn't sometimes. It can often come through for you, because your opponents get so used to using fighting against the standard stuff, they don't think about the creative stuff that could be out there. Which many YouTubers may actually agree with me on, because I do know a few YouTubers that do use creative sets. So, you know, it goes for a Mach Punch. Of course it's going to knock out my Electivire, because, well, you know, I didn't have much health to begin with. In fact, it probably could have paired me without those Baton Pass boosts. So, but Vaporeon goes for an Aqua Wing. I guess that makes sense. You know, well, yeah, of course it makes sense. You know, it's a bit of a defensive war, and it goes well with Leftovers, so yeah, pretty good set there. Wouldn't surprise me if it has Wish as well. Go for a Hydro Pump here. Really was hoping to get the Hitmonchan, but unfortunately I missed. But in all fairness, I doubt it would have hit anyway, because chances, Hitmonchan does actually have pretty good special defense. And he goes for a Sky Uppercut. Sure you can. And that knocks me out, so I'll admit I lost fair and square, you know, unlike that guy on PBR 210. Yeah, this guy was actually a good player. So my hat's off to him, and I'll see you all in the next battle, and see you later.